It's that time of year again! It's NaNoWriMo time. Hey guys, I'm Kate. Welcome back to my channel, and today I'm talking Camp NaNoWriMo prep. I know I said it's that time of year again, but camp's not until April, but I'm gonna get into why it starts for me a little bit early. NaNoWriMo always starts for me a little bit earlier than it's supposed to because I do a whole month of prep work. I've said it before and I'll say it again, my writing life is kind of measured around when NaNoWriMo and when the camps are. Because of course, if you participate in the two Camp NaNoWriMos and then NaNoWriMo in November, that's 3 months out of your year already. And for me, I try and always do a first draft during those times, which then makes the rest of the year perfect for a revising editing schedule. So my year looks a little something like this. Nano months, April, July, November. Then you have your prep months. I do a whole month of prep. I used to be a pantser and then I evolved. Not that everyone's evolution will look like pantser to planner. Some will have the reverse, but for me, old buddy. I've gone full planner. Full planner. So then my prep months are March, June, and October, and then my revision months are January, February, May, August, and September. And then December is just like its own time of year that I like to call hibernation. Or, you know, family, food, friends, look at all the pretty lights. But I don't write. I do nothing story related in December. Honestly, I don't do anything in December, period. But now we are in March, and that means it's prep time. Prep time, prep time. So how do we prep? I made Preptober videos in October of last year, which is a much catchier name than anything that I could come up with for March, which honestly was just like, prep March, super creative. Preparch, prarch, no, none of those work. So if you want to go check those out, I think the information is still useful for the camps, even though it's not the November NaNoWriMo. But this time I will be prepping alongside my informational videos because, of course, it's just now March. So I haven't done any prep work. And that's what this month is for. And the first obvious step for any good prep month is figuring out what story you're gonna write. Now I will confess, I've done this plenty of times before where I've gotten to like the 11th hour and then changed my mind. I have picked a totally different story to work on than the one I spent a month prepping for. Probably not a spoiler, but I don't recommend you do this. I don't recommend I do this. It doesn't usually work out well for me for the longevity of the month, but each time I feel like, who am I to refuse inspiration's call? A writer who should know better, to be honest. I always have the problem where I have multiple stories that I want to choose from. At any given time, I have probably 3 or 4 stories that are in different stages of brainstorming. So then the hard part is kind of trying to decipher between all of those ideas and think which could I actually write for the month, which I already maybe know the most about, and then which would be potentially the most viable that other people would want to read. And that's not something you necessarily have to take into consideration because I think you should write whatever you want to. Like I did last NaNoWriMo, I wrote a sci-fi story just for the sake of me exploring a new genre. So I try and go into each camp and NaNoWriMo kind of with my own personal goal for that session, and I will get to that in my next prep video. So of the 4 or 5 stories that I kind of sort of maybe am starting to have a good idea about, I will go into my prep month now and think which I have the most information on, and if I don't have a good idea for a beginning, a middle, or an end for a certain story, I cross that one off. Because I like to let my ideas kind of ruminate in my brain, and so if I haven't come up with it yet, the odds that it's going to magically fall into my lap, not super high. Not for me. And this, I'm not saying you have to know everything because that's what we're gonna get the rest of the month for. I mean just a general, this is how it starts. Here's like a thing that needs to happen in the middle, and here is what I think I know I want the ending to be. And so going into March, I have 3 story ideas that meet that requirement. The first one is a sci-fi style dystopian where the whole world can no longer have children, and the story is going to follow the youngest person in the world. So I have the who, the what, the why, and I have the ending that I'm honestly, I've never written an ending like this before, and I'm really excited for it. And then my second idea is a story that's like The Princess Bride meets Scooby-Doo. And I love both of those things so much, and so it's honestly a wonder I didn't think of something like this before. And
Ooh.
In my head, it's a multiple book kind of series. Like, I actually have the arcs that would need to happen in the second and third book. And then I have the big twist that happens toward the end of the first book. So I feel like I know enough about this that that one is feasible too. And then my third option is a new adult romance book, which I've written about 6 chapters in, and I have semi sort of outlined, but I had to sideline it because I was working on other projects. This one is harder for me because it's basically a contemporary, more or less, and I'm reading more and more contemporaries kind of to prep for this book, but also it's, I usually write specific genres, and so it's like an entirely new thing where I keep worrying that I don't have enough, that I don't have enough plot to fulfill an entire novel's worth. So it could be a good thing if I wanted to choose that as my goal for the month, which of course is what Preparch, what the month is for anyways, but you know, I gotta choose it first. So, how do you choose when you have multiple ideas? How do I choose? I'm trying to choose right now as I'm filming. If I change my mind, you'll know next video. I think you just have to gauge how excited you are for each project, and if you're equally excited for all of them, I think you kind of start semi-plotting them, like a little bit more bare-bonesy outline, and I think as you do that, you will inevitably be more excited for one of them. You may just have more material for one of them. I think that's the one you choose, but I'm gonna do it a different way. Arguably a dumb way. Ish. It's debatable. I want to save the Princess Bride meets Scooby-Doo one for next Camp NaNoWriMo in July because I think once I let that sit after I finish it in July, it'll be perfect time to reread the closer it is to Halloween. I think that would just be so fun because it would be like a horror-ish, a horror spoof. So I think I would already be in the mood and yeah, so I think I'm gonna save that for July. Unless I have another idea then and I'll have to reevaluate. But anyways, I'm not gonna do that one right now. So now I'm down to the new adult romance or the young adult sci-fi dystopian. And actually, depending on how I write it, I wouldn't necessarily categorize it as young adult, but again, that's what prep month is for. I guess I'll see. And what I'm comparing those to, I think I'm just more personally excited for that one, for the potentially young adult sci-fi dystopian, just because I think I still have some like underlying feelings about this new adult romance that I can't quite get sorted out. And I like to be excited for my Camp NaNoWriMo and NaNoWriMo projects because you're writing so many words so quickly and that's kind of my drafting style anyways. But I think having as much enthusiasm as possible is what's going to make you the most successful. So I guess I've made my decision. All right, that's it for this video. Next Preparch. I can't even say that with a straight face anymore. Like, next time I'm going to be talking about goals and freight tags pyramid unless I think of something else in the meantime, in which case, look forward to that. Please comment down below and let me know if you're participating in Camp NaNoWriMo, if you've already started prepping, and if you already have a cabin, because I don't and I would love some cabin mates. And then also tell me if you already know what story or at least kind of like what genre you're writing in. Thank you guys so much for watching and I will see y'all very soon with a new video. Bye. If you're a prepper, if you're going to be prepping for Camp NaNoWriMo, I guess if you're participating in Camp NaNoWriMo, that would be a good first question to ask. And so going into March, prep arch, prarch. Oops. Because I'm dying.